Now let us continue with the second page, page number 34. He held out a glass of steaming tea in his hand. Masterji, he asked once more, his voice filled with concern. The old man looked up. His face was ashen. He looked old and very tired. He beckoned the boy to come closer and motioned him to sit down. Now this boy, Salim, he held out the glass of steaming tea in his hand and he just told Masterji to take it and drink it. So he asked once more and his voice was filled with concern because he could read the emotions on Masterji's face. And the old man looked up, but his face was ashen. Face was ashen means it looked pale. It was looking very dull. He looked old and very tired and he beckoned the boy. Beckon means to call the boy. So he called the boy to come closer and then he motioned him to sit down. He just motioned him means just signaled him. Okay, gave him a signal to sit down. Salim, he said gently, soon I will be the last stonemason here. All the others would have gone to Agra. There they are turning out cheap candle stands, paperweights and ashtrays by the dozens. They are making money, but they betray our skill, our age-old tradition. Now Gopal is also gone. I will have to finish this sculpture alone. And with the help of God, I will do it, Salim. So now Masterji is telling about his son, that his son has left him. He was actually sad and he was telling him that he would be the last stonemason here. Here means actually in that place, in that particular town or village. All the others would have gone to Agra. Means actually many had already gone to Agra and the others would also be going soon, just as his son had just left. They are turning out cheap candle stands, paperweights and ashtrays. These small little things, small little articles of stone actually don't need any particular kind of art as such, okay? It just doesn't need any fine piece of art. They are just made into simple shapes, candle stands in a circular shape, paperweights, okay, all those things. So they are making money. Yes, they are sold because they are sold in many numbers, okay? Because one particular thing can be sold in a great number at a particular shop. So they are making money, but they betray our skill, our age-old tradition. So he was actually not happy with the son leaving him like this. And he was left alone to finish the sculpture which he was already working on. And he had the determination. He said, no, with the help of God, I will do it, Salim. I know you will, Masterji, the boy answered. You will make many more large and more beautiful temple sculptures. So this boy was actually trying to motivate Masterji and he said, yes, I know you will. And you will make many more. Not only this, but you will make many more and many more beautiful temple sculptures. So the old man looked at the orphan boy who had come to work for him 5 years ago. Drenched to the skin, dressed in tatters, he had begged for shelter during a furious monsoon storm and had stayed on to work for the old master craftsman. He had grown tall and strong now. The old man knew that Salim too would leave him one day. Now, this boy, Salim, actually was working as a servant in the house of this Masterji. But he had come as an orphan. He had not come for any job as such. He was just an orphan boy. 5 years ago, he had come to take shelter only during a rainy. It was a monsoon storm, but a furious monsoon storm. And so he was all drenched in water. He was he did not have proper clothes. He was just dressed in tatters. And he came looking for shelter for a night. And Masterji, this stonemason, he had felt pity on him. He let him in the house. And then when the boy was ready to work, he said, I'm ready to work at your place. if you allow me. So he had actually allowed him to work as a servant in his house. So now he was living there only for the last 5 years. So Salim had now grown tall and strong, and the old man knew Salim too would leave him one day. So the old man actually thought that Salim also, now that he has become grown up and he has learned to work, so he also might leave him one day. He sighed and looked into the serious eyes of the boy, clouded with sadness, a sadness the old man could not understand. He shook his head. "My strength is waning. I can't work with this chisel like I used to. Carving takes too long, much too long." So now he sighed, he looked into the serious eyes of the boy with sadness. Sighed means actually a look of sadness. Clouded with sadness, a sadness the old man could not understand. And he said, "My strength is waning," means his strength is decreasing. Waning means something which is reducing. And he was admitting that he was not able to work with a chisel as he used to work, okay, when he was young and strong. So then he straightened up and said with fresh determination, "I will have to finish this work, and I surely will." So at times he was feeling very weak, but still he was strong with determination. And so he used to again say, "No, no, I have to finish this work, and I surely, I will." "Yes, you will," the boy repeated, offering this master the glass of tea. "Drink, please. It will do you good." Then he added, "I have to go to the market for an hour or two, but I'll be back in time to prepare dinner." So he just informed the stonemason, the old man, that "you please drink this tea," and he has to go to the market. He'll be back in an hour or two before the dinner time. So the old man nodded and thought, "He has been going to the market too often lately. I hope he hasn't fallen into bad company." Now the old man did not know why this boy was going out very often lately, and he was just hoping that the boy had not fallen into any bad company with some other boys. Okay, but then he wanted to know where he was going. He just gave him a questioning glance. He shot a questioning glance at the boy, who turned and left the room. But the boy did not answer, did not reply anything. He did not tell him where he was going, but he just left the room quietly. So I'll continue with this, the next part in my next video.